And now let's welcome Trina Pricahrd on day 6, retros. Woohoo! Take it over for Trina.
Okay. We're doing introducing retro avoiding dates. Which is unwanted behavior. So on to retro avoiding states. So our origin story, it all started innocently enough. One day, a normal resource state carried out a behavior, and it was noticed that whilst going through that process behavior, that the personality was safe and protected from unresolved emotions and feelings. And because the activity or behavior saved the purpose of protecting the personality from the unwanted emotions, it was sometimes returned to more and more often for the relief it provided. Makes sense, because none of us want to have to endure unwanted feelings. When the personality loses an ability to stop returning to this activity, it has become a retro avoiding state, a retro avoiding behavior, and a retro avoiding state is born.
great slide.
And this is how you pick us in a lineup. So we perform unwanted behavior that the other states just don't like. We feel the work we do is extremely important. We're unemotional, unlike our vated states friends. Mm-hmm. We're highly focused. We want what's best for the personality, and we believe we're helping. We really do. We'll take one for the team and push through being disliked in an attempt to save the personality from feelings of not being lovable, not feeling worthy, feelings of not being enough, rejection, feelings of fear, inadequacy, just to name a few. Mm-hmm. We're used to being disliked by the other parts, and we don't expect them to like us. We feel very much in control when we're in the conscious. It may seem like we're not, but in fact, we are very in control, and it's the other states that aren't. We've become experts at making the personality feel safe during our behavior in order to avoid the negative feelings of the associated beta states. We feel extremely useful. And our behavior is capable of shielding the unwanted feelings of a evaded state. However, after the fact, the other states will regret our behavior. Mm. And we overpower all the other states. And basically, we will just block anyone else. No one can get a look in while we're in control in the conscious. We just completely block you.
Great.
So we have many tricks in our book and up our sleeve as a way of avoiding the feelings. And this is how in our minds we save you. We use these behaviors to help you avoid the painful, and when I say you, I mean the personality, avoid the painful emotions and the feelings of the associated evaded states. So, you know, we can use self-harm, obsessive shopping, porn addiction, obsessive eating, OCD behavior, perfectionism, gambling, workaholism, work avoidance, eating disorders. And, you know, we've got many more up our sleeve, addiction, drug taking, just to name a few. But we've got many and varied ways that we can, you know, just save you from those feelings. Hmm. And at a closer look, our behavior includes all psychological addictions and any other behavior that is not able to be controlled by the patient. It's our purpose to protect the personality from the unwanted feelings of fear or rejection, and we're willing to be unpopular to make this happen. We overdo a behavior like gambling and all the others listed, and even more, to help the person to avoid having bad feelings. We usually make our appearance in adulthood, and we're brilliant at helping the personality to avoid the upset feelings of states evaded with fear or rejection. In many instances, the personality will find it far more comfortable to just be zoned out while we perform our behavior than to feel the feelings of anxiety and the evaded state feelings. It's easy to see when we offer such protection and avoidance from these unwanted feelings, why we'd be returned to over and over and over again, to the point where the personality just simply can't stop. Unfortunately, after the behavior has been performed, the other states are extremely regretful and at times quite surprised. Other ways to help identify us is when the client is complaining about his or her behavior as opposed to feelings, that'd be us. I can't believe I did that. I hate myself when I do that. I wish I didn't do that. And a few other sentences that start with WTF, us, and yep, us. We're the impetus for all these phrases and regret. Just can't help it. So here we have just a bit of an example how it works. You know, we've got little Belle and she's in her dungeon. She's got all the feelings of being lonely and afraid, scared, rejected, not good enough, alone, unlovable, abandoned, vulnerable, unworthy, all of those things. And then we have the beast, aka the retro-avoiding state. It sees Belle amongst all these horrible emotions. It goes, what's a nice girl like you doing in a place like this amongst all these horrible emotions and feelings? And then he says, let me take you away from all this. And she says, but the other states will hate you. But then he really, frankly, my dear, I don't give a damn. He doesn't care that he'll be unhate. He'll be hated. He just wants to get little Belle the hell out of those feelings. Mm-hmm. And then, you know, so in that, we'll take you away from all this and let's go shopping or a multitude of other things that the avoiding state, retro avoiding state could choose from. Mm. And then help you help me. So just so that we can help the therapist have its best chance of helping return us to normalcy. Mm. We're just a little misunderstood. At first glance, to the untrained eye, our behaviors may make it seem like we're anything but helpful. After all, the behaviors we perform are unwanted, but our intention is pure, protective, and good. It's usually another part of the personality that is pretty done with our antics and takes us all into therapy. The good news is we can and we will change our behavior if the conditions are just right. There's a natural order to things. So first of all, efforts to change us prior to the associated evaded state resolution being conducted are futile. In our way of thinking, that would be like leaving the personality exposed and unprotected with no escape plan. Doesn't sound like us. So it's imperative there's been evaded state resolution so that our services are no longer required, or at least not to the same degree or in the same manner. If the associated evaded state has been resolved, our avoiding behavior is no longer needed. And in order for the therapist to help us, they'll have to bring the evaded state fully to the conscious by vivifying one particular moment that initiated the painful feelings of the evaded state that we usually rescue them from. If work is attempted with us directly without the evaded state being first returned to normalcy, we, in all honesty, would just be making empty promises that would go out the window at the first sign of trouble or unwanted emotion. So again, the first port of call is to, through RT Action 2, vivify the specific. So we want to bring out the evaded state that is being avoided. So the most successful way of doing this is by getting the patient to describe the point immediately prior to us making our appearance with our unwanted avoiding behavior. For example, if we usually help Miss Tiffany by checking locks and doors, it would be great for the therapist to ask Tiffany to describe what she feels like lying in bed just before she gets up to check the locks and doors. In other words, just before we swoop in and do our thing. And then having Tiffany lay there for an extended period of time and therefore delaying our behavior is what brings the evaded state to the surface. So when the anxiety of evaded state is evident, it's showtime for the next step of the next action of bridging. So finding the correct evaded state is the most important aspect of stopping our retro-avoiding behavior. Once the evaded state is brought to the surface and resolved, there's no need for our behavior anymore. RT actions 3 to 7 can then be carried out identically as to how they would be implemented to help any resource state faded with fear or rejection. But let's not stop here. We have to cover all our bases when we're doing this. So without any further steps being carried out, there is a possibility that we could stop our behavior permanently. But sometimes we'll return when we're using unwanted behavior to help our personality to avoid the feelings of the evaded state. In all honesty, unless we're given a new way to behave, chances are at some point in the future, the patient, our personality, may become emotionally distressed. And there's a pretty good chance that if push comes to shove, we'll just go straight back to the avoiding behavior we know and nobody loves in an attempt to help our personality reduce distress. So it's really important that we take care of all that so that we don't default to the other behavior. Deal. Action 10, retro state negotiation. Personally, as a retro avoiding state, I love this action. It's where I become understood and the true purpose behind my behavior is revealed. Whilst it may have been touched on briefly earlier, it's here that I feel most acknowledged and understood. In this RT action, it's discovered and really explored what the positive intention behind my unwanted behavior was all along. Negotiations commence to establish another, more desirable way we can achieve the same goal if needed in the future. So we must warn you here though, that speaking for all the retro avoiding states, you catch more bees with honey than vinegar, and we want to be praised. Tell us how appreciative you are of what we have done in the past. You don't have to praise our behavior, but definitely our positive intention behind the behavior and also our willingness to be unliked by all the other resources in the process. While we still won't be putty in your hands initially, we'll be far more willing to interview a new role. And I say interview because you're not going to get us to commit to a new role before a different state is asked if it will like us once the new proposed role's adopted. We want to test the waters, be sure and hear it from the other state's mouth directly that if we were to take on this new activity, it would like us. We respond well to positive feedback like everybody else, and we want the confirmation directly from the appropriate states that they will in fact like us and value us in a new role. Turns out our love language may just be positive words of affirmation. So encouragement from the other states goes a long way in these negotiations as we're a little trepidatious. These are uncharted territories for us and we're not used to being liked by the other states, but we could get used to it. And as is common for all successful negotiations, upon completion of the negotiating process, all parties involved should feel happy with the result and express this freely to one another. So it's very important to get that crosstalk between the different states to build those connections. So you really want to encourage them to thank each other and express their gratitude and their happiness and willingness. And just like Sally Field's acceptance speech, you really want to be liked. So in the negotiations, you know, no one's getting fired, just retired, repurposed, and it's always with love and appreciation. So on many occasions, the negotiation results in us taking on a lesser role, semi-retirement, retirement, or being repurposed, or our behavior being adapted, which allows us to still achieve the positive intention we were going for from the get-go, but in a more desirable, less destructive way. And guess what? We're liked in the process by the other resources. In some negotiations, we hand the reins over to another part, completely moving forward for the times that we were previously, perhaps not so effectively. And this is achieved by using RT Action 8, Find Resource. However, we're still there on the inside, just monitoring and ready and willing to come to the conscious if and when our behavior is beneficial to and or necessary for the safety of our personality. Now in this one, there's a bit of a typo here or something that I just didn't quite fix. So if in the past, prior to the evaded state resolution and retro state negotiation, we may have swooped in a bit too much gusto, velocity and energy when Bob walked past a fence with a 3-kilogram poodle yapped at him. we may have in the past made Bob run like a maniac while screaming at the sound or sight of the poodle because we wanted to keep him safe. Here's this little thing I should have fixed up. He wasn't seven. That would be original. He was 17, 27 if he was a day. So young Bob at 27 walks past, and it turns out he was attacked by a dog. As a result, he has a state vated with fear. However, after vated state resolution and the following negotiations, we're happy to let another part of Bob enjoy his afternoon walk in suburbia, be amused by the cute little yapping poodle behind the fence, but we'll be there on the inside, just kicking back with one eye open, just in case a pack of wild dogs happens to appear in his path. Bob can count on us in that moment to get him the hell out, and that will be our time to shine if and when that scenario ever happens. In the past, we were unliked by the other parts because our behavior was a little bit, punishment doesn't fit the crime, a bit too much overkill, and may have caused Bob embarrassment amongst other things after the event. Now, however, because we're just sitting back and watching in case Bob really needs us, all the other parts love us and see us as a valued and needed part of the team. Our intention all along was to keep Bob safe. So that still is our intention, but it's now done just in a more resourceful way that's not causing harm to the other states. Another example of this is, the lady that comes home from work and she enters the empty house and she's feeling lonely, and she would in previous times just mow the fridge down, whatever the contents of the fridge down. But after the vated state resolution and some negotiations, you're hoping that she doesn't need that anymore. But if in a time in the future, something like that makes those feelings come to the surface again, she's got a more resourceful way to deal with that, whether it's, meditation, going to the gym, that kind of thing. A roll of the dice. So this is why some people can dabble and walk away and other people become heavily addicted, and it's all down to the vated states. So as touched on, psychological addictions are caused by vated states. Addictions are us, the retro-avoiding states, at our most cleverest. In the form of addiction, we are actually clever coping mechanisms to avoid the experience of a vated state. Whether it's drug addiction, gambling addiction, or even workaholism, that's us providing some of our biggest and cleverest coping and avoiding mechanisms. And sadly, some of our most detrimental also, but you won't hear that from us. A resource can be so vated with an experience so absolutely overwhelming that escaping from that feeling into addictive behavior is easily the lesser of evils, and we want to help so badly that we oblige. At this time, we consider ourselves a helping resource, a subconscious process, as we provide a way to relieve the psyche from the experience of the vated state. The bright lights of a casino, the risk of losing money, the in general zoning out experience of walking into a casino and all that comes with it can create a relieving diversion from a vated state that holds overwhelming unpleasant feelings. So similarly, we offer retro-avoiding behavior in the form of drug taking, as the drugs can block states from coming into the conscious. Individuals experiencing the terrible, overwhelming angst of vated states will find it really appealing to have this behavior knock the vated state and all the emotional pain that comes with it out of the conscious in order to feel the peace the drug taking, our retro-avoiding behavior, provides. And some people can dabble and experiment with drugs without ever becoming addicted, while others become highly addicted quite quickly at times. It's likely that the individuals who dabble without becoming addicted don't have vated states to a level that creates a need for them to escape. Lucky buggers. And the only way to remove the psychological need for the drug is to resolve the vated state that the drug has blocked with the retro-avoiding behavior, helping state drug use. So similarly to the other retro-avoiding behaviors, these resources referred to here as helping resources that have used drugs to provide relief to the personalities need to feel respected. The drug-taking resource is usually heavily abused, misunderstood both by other people as well as the other resources of the client. And it feels so important, feels like unless it does its thing, helping the person to cope, that there will just be so much extreme pain. the best way to get this personality part on side is to thank it for the help that it has given in the past and let it know that it is important and that it will be available in the future to help the client in other ways. So it's always ideal to have all resources cooperating with the therapist. If a resource believes that it is not respected or the therapist is against it, it's likely to not cooperate. Another important part of helping a client with an addiction is resolving the Vedic state. When the resource that had previously felt overwhelmingly uncomfortable when coming to the conscious finds peace and support and care, then there's no longer a need to escape from the state into addictive behavior. And this is the case no matter what kind of addiction the client presents with. It's very common for individuals to find an addictive behavior that they can live with that helps them to block the experience of a evaded state. These may include things on the surface don't appear to be detrimental or problematic, like gardening, cooking, cleaning, painting, workaholism. They're kind of a more highly respected thing, but it's not ideal when individuals feel a compulsion to do something, even if it's something as seemingly harmless as gardening. It's more that the compulsion, the compelling nature, is an indication that they feel out of control. So some people can become so used to having an addiction that they just don't want it to end. And an example of this is the workaholic. Whilst the workaholic may yield really wonderful accomplishments and achievements, they fear slowing down or working less because they know that, you know, it's in those quieter moments that the opportunity exists for evaded states to surface if they are in existence. So even if it's a seemingly, you know, respectable or good thing, it's more the indication that if they can't stop doing it, there's work to be done. So the beauty of the RT actions and the retro-avoiding states being returned to normalcy. Resources in the normal condition exhibit psychological health. They function well externally and within the personality. They are liked and valued by the other states. And when evaded states are resolved, the gift that comes with that resolution is avoiding behavior no longer being necessary. And therefore, new, more welcomed and non-compulsive behavior is adopted. It's the purpose of resource therapy for all states to achieve a normal condition, and in that fulfillment, our moments become our own to work, to relax, to choose how and with who we get to spend our oh so precious moments. And who doesn't love a happy ending? Let's give a big thank you to Philippa, Chris, and Yvette for the wonderful training, and to the other beautiful participants for being so giving, kind, and supportive. I just wish I could see you.
Yay! Woo! Thank you.